Well, I'm supposed to let you know about the wonderful new merch drop that's happening right now on mavmadeit.com, but we also have our own billboard. And yes, that is a working phone number. In order to find the location of this and this billboard, you gotta give that number a ring and see if you can find the coordinates. Just click on the description below and the coordinates are posted. First come, first serve. Same can be said for all of the new stuff on the website, so check it out and get it while it lasts. Thanks for all the support. Day of cleaning. Lots of things are super messy still from life on the Dalton Highway. Still here in Fairbanks, Alaska, having myself a little bit of lunch and trying to decide what to do with my day. At least it smells nice in here. Alright, well, I didn't film as much today as I thought I was going to, but I got a lot done. I shipped out some videos, I organized the truck, got my fresh new sheets put on, planned my next few days in Alaska. We're getting down to the end of the trip here, so I want to be sure I'm using my time wisely, one for myself and two to make the best content that I can, so. Oh, that is a red light.
Tomorrow I'm gonna get to go fishing,
camping, and we're heading back towards Anchorage. All right, well, we are stealthily camping in a hotel parking lot tonight. So I'm too lazy to go try to find wilderness. Hopefully it's not an issue. Alright. Alright, it's 45 degrees. It's actually pretty nice out. Sheets are a little damp. We'll survive. Let's get some rest. Good night. It's a sunny morning here in Alaska. I'd say that this is probably one out of 5 days in the time that I've been here where it's been this nice and sunny. Woo! We're gonna enjoy it today. I think you need to get cleaned up, buddy, finally. It's time to get rid of this mess. For the most part, nights here have been getting into the low 30s, and daytime has been 50 as a high. But today, we're getting a high of 59, and it's supposed to be 40 at night, so it's actually very, very nice. The sun's also very nice. Thank you. like I'm dirty now. That looks pretty good. I'm filthy though. Over the last couple weeks, I haven't done too much fishing just because the weather's been kind of bummy. I'm gonna take advantage of the hot sun today, and I'm gonna go try to catch myself an Arctic grayling, which is a very odd looking fish that I've never caught before. And I think you can only catch here. The mornings when I'm in my truck, I find it kind of a waste of time to make breakfast unless I'm hanging out with someone and trying to impress them. So if I'm feeling like having a big breakfast, I'll usually go out. But if I have too many days in a row where I go out, I start to feel fat. So we have bananas and Greek yogurt. And before I hit the river today, I'm gonna take advantage of being in civilization and hit the gym to get a shower and to work my muscles. Want to hear what I'm listening to? Before I leave, I'm trying to see the ever so famous magic bus from Into the Wild. If you don't know, it was filmed here in Fairbanks, and actually the true story took place in Denali National Park. So they have the bus here. It's getting refurbished right now, waiting to be put in the museum. And apparently you can still see it from inside the University of Fairbanks. It's the bus formerly known as 142 from the book and movie and real life story of Into the Wild. If you haven't read it, it's a great read. Wow, pretty jealous of this campus. It's absolutely gorgeous. But on one of my last days here in Alaska, I don't really want to spend the whole time on a college campus. Let's get back on the truck and go find a spot to fish. In a measly 2 days, I've got to be in Anchorage because I'm actually flying to a very cool destination here in Alaska. From Fairbanks to Anchorage, we're about 7 hours away, so we're gonna do some of that drive today and cook ourselves a nice meal because I've been eating out too much, man. I really have been. Oh my gosh, it's absolutely beautiful. 55 degrees here. Right now I'm driving the Parks Highway, heading toward Denali. Eventually gonna make it back to Anchorage. I've got about an hour and a half before I reach the final grocery store before I find my camp spot for the night. So that's where we're gonna stop first. All right, so I'm here at Three Bears in Healy, Alaska, just past the Stampede Trail, which is where that bus was actually recovered from. This this is the last grocery store that I can access before I get to my river and camping spot for the night, so stock up quick. Thank you very much. Have a good rest of your day. Called the Denali Highway, and in a few short months, well, actually, probably a few short weeks, this road's gonna be closed down for the winter. I'm surprised it's actually still open right now. I'm gonna see if I can find myself a camp spot, because there are a lot of rivers down here that should be holding fish. It's getting later in the evening, so I'm not really sure how much fishing I'm gonna be able to do, but I'm hoping to at least find some prime real estate for sleeping tonight. With how clear of a day we've got, it's a perfect day to admire Denali National Park. Wow. We're stopped here, waiting for more road construction stuff. But man, those mountains look good today. Last time I drove through here, it was all fog, so it's nice to actually see something. Alright, let's go. Got my waders on real fast. Got some bear spray in my pouch. We got a new river to fish. Alright, you can see this river is a lot more clear. This isn't a glacial river, so the grayling are more likely to be in here. It's moving pretty fast, so we'll see if I can find somewhere that's a little bit slower. Right now I'm just walking the river looking for fish activity. This looks pretty nice. Slow-ish. We'll give it a try. This is what I'm using. This is called a dry fly. It sits on top of the water. Somebody put that juice on it earlier. That's actually just to make it a little more water resistant. I'm gonna have the hardest time seeing this, but. Uh-oh. Found something. Come on. Let go, would ya? I'm gonna go down just a little bit further, but this is not looking too promising for me. So fast. I suppose I'll go down a little bit further, but it's not looking great. The stretch river's starting to slow down a bit. One thing that's got me worried, that looks like brown bear. If I'm not mistaken, didn't look like the droplings we were seeing earlier. Yeah. That's as far as I go. Yeah, it's still pretty fast over here. But we gotta try. We walked all the way over here. I can't fish this. Well, I could, but there's no point. It looked better from the trail. Still pretty fast.
All right.
Howdy. No grailing for me this trip. That was tough. I'll have to come back when the water's slower. Oh, that walking made me hungry. This recipe comes from Colton in Fairbanks. That was fitting because just left there. And he said, takes time and a few extra spices to buy, but it's delicious. So we're making French onion beef noodle soup tonight. Thought it sounded nice on a chilly fall evening. Better time to break up the pressure cooker.
I don't know if he's trolling me, man, but he's trying to get me to make 3 pounds of short ribs and 5 pounds of onions.
Boy.
It also says to cook the meat for 14 minutes. All right. You know what, bro? I don't know who taught you to cook, but I'm doing my own thing. Bro's got to be cooking for an army.
Next, we're going to take an onion, and I want to keep this thing round, so I'm going to peel it quick. Sled dogs are popular here, but so are wolves and coyotes. I don't know what that is. We are in the middle of a wildlife reserve, so hopefully they're not too big of fans of French onion soup.
All right. I'm gonna pull apart the meat. It's nice and tender. There we go. Put that on simmer. Pretty soon we're gonna add our noodles.
All right, I turned on the diesel heater because it's getting kind of cold out actually. It got down to like 35. Right now it's sitting at 64 in here, which is nice. Could have just been that there's so much moisture in the air from making stock. Got about 30 minutes left on the soup, and then gotta cook the noodles. Noodles going in. Massage the noodle. Oh. I did have to MacGyver some of this recipe, but it did turn out looking pretty good. The broth was too watery before, and I just added the beef packet from a ramen noodle package to get some sodium in there and some beef flavor, because apparently I didn't make my stock right. That's tasty. That's yummy. Combines two of my favorite things. French onion soup and ramen. Oh. Thanks, Colton, for the recipe. Still really confused as to why there was a recipe like enough to feed 60 people on there, but maybe it was for after you make the soup, because it's so good you're gonna want like 60 servings. Either way, if you guys wanna leave me a recipe, go over to mavmadeit.com. There's a contact section where you can fill out a recipe box and send one in to me. Really appreciate it. I'm sweating so hard. Now that I shut my fan off, I can hear the river. That's awesome. We're only about 100 feet away from it, but there's a lot of woods like in between. It's thick. No dolly today. It's okay. Can't do it all. This gives me more reason to come back, right? Feels good to be out in the wilderness. We did a lot today. Now the only thing I can think about is going to bed. Luckily, I'm not seeing anybody, so don't have to worry about my onion breath. I also must not know how to do deadlifts because my low back is sore. All right, well. Oh my god, my legs are sore. Do leg day, they said, and then walk 2 miles. Dude, I'm wiped out. Alright, I'm gonna go to bed. I will see you in the morning. Just in case. I've got juice. Morning. It's another beautiful day here in Alaska, heading down from Denali to Anchorage right now, and look who decided to join the party. My dearest friend, Mr. Check. Hey, buddy. CE light came on today. So we're gonna have to find a place to rest relatively soon. The good news is it's not flashing, so it's not an emergency, but I'm hoping it's not what I think it is, which would be a blown cylinder. If it is, that could be the end of this truck. Hurts to say, but it very well could be. And those will actually like make a noise?
Well, essentially what it's doing is if it's not reading right, then technically it's gonna tell the computer like, hey, you know, something's wrong, and it seems that I can find it.
Oh, okay. So that'll start making weird noises. Can I still drive it with what's going on?
I wouldn't drive it a lot.
Yeah. How much does that cost usually? Like, just rough. I'm not gonna hold you to it. But
$3,000?
God, I need to get rid of this thing. So that's not just replacing the sensor, that's replacing the whole shaft? Or the whole timing belt?
No, yeah, the timing belt, everything.
Okay. Just come back in on Monday?
Yeah, just come back and whatever you wanna do.
Alright, so I just dropped it off. We're getting an oil change done on it first, because we had that weird oil thing going on when we were up in Prudhoe Bay. And then it's been yelling at me to get the oil change for a little bit. Let's see if that helps. The code says that the cam phasers are being funky, but if the oil's funky, that could in turn make the cam phasers funky, so we'll see. Fingers crossed.